Hello, yes, this video has made wonders for me because a lot of people have been asking how I do this, and trust me, it was very interesting that most people thought that these are the knotless braids and I just held them puff to add that extension. But trust me, it was very, very hard for me because you can see how I try to make this arched so that it can come out. So like, if you'd like to watch with me to go through all the detail on how to do it, please let's consider this.
Maurice, the Crochet Master.
Oh yes, my name is Maurice, the Crochet Master, and I would like to welcome everyone who is watching right now. Yes, this video just made it was 3 million views on TikTok in just like 2 days. And most people were asking me about its tutorial, and I decided to bring it here so that you can see how it was, the process was, and how it was really very, very tricky for me because it was my first time and it was just a creativity. So this is how I tried to make my lines, and I realized if I do the knotless, there's the weight might be, maybe it might be a lot on someone's head, and if you try to hold a puff, it's the braids might be a lot. So I decided to make sure that I make my lines like this. So you make these lines according to this, following the circle shape. Yes, we are following the circle shape until we reach the center. So where you see your lines, where it stops is where you also stop. Yes, if your lines is passing through, like where you don't see the hair, yes, you can stop it. There's no need of skipping, you understand? So because now if you try to look at these, that those lines that we are stopping on the foreheads, you understand, like these two lines we're stopping on the forehead, and you're now finding the third one is the one that is going joining the first line in front. So that's how tricky it is. But I had to make sure that I make the whole line to reach on my center, and this is the center. So now when I reached here, I realized that my puff is in front, it is so much in front, and then I had to create another line because when you see behind, there are like four lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, in fact 5, and then in front there were only 2. So in order to balance the head, I'm just trying to create another one here in front so that it can at least try to balance, you understand? Because now this one, if you don't, it means the puff is going to be in on the center, like not even the center, it will be like in front, and then this extension won't be able to be there perfectly. So it is in the two ways. You may decide to start in like here. You may start with this and then you go circling until the first line, but sometimes still it is tricky because we need like our lines to be perfect from down, because at least we may do mistakes in the middle, but when the front or the behind is perfect. So that's why I would advise, still let's start from down, at least we end here, because now you can see how our circle is ending from here. At least I've tried to manage the circle to be at least a little bit behind, because now we are going to add the extension in front. So all this is done according to someone's head shape. I know you're going to get somebody with a head shape that is going to be maybe perfect for you, when the whole she has the hair all over. Yes, like even when the if the hairline is not broken, it just might be lucky for you, and then you do it right. But for me, mine, as we saw, like the two lines from behind, they're all stopping on the foreheads, and then the third one is the one that we're trying to connect. But for you, you might find like the first line or the second line is already joining with the first. So that's how you manage to do it. And then when we are doing it, we have to follow the knotless way format, doing it in a knotless way format. And I believe even if we don't do the knotless way, we can still do the inside knotless. I'm going to try to do something else with the inside knotless so that we see which one can be perfect for us. And anyway, like not even being perfect, but something that can last longer with the knotless or with the inside knotless. So that's what we shall do the next. And yes, I just try to think about a style, hairstyle, and this is what I got. You know, sometimes I always advise my clients that it is always good at least you get that communication with your hairstylist, because most of the times we are the one who knows like those protective hairstyle that we can play it for your hair. Maybe if you have come with a broken hairline and I choose a hairstyle for you, and please try to accept it. I know sometimes maybe we might choose a hairstyle that it is in that you won't be interested with, but trust me, if it's something that is going to help our hairline to come back, you can just do it for those 3 months, and your hairline, when the hairline comes back, there you can do anything that you feel you want. Because most of the times it is always very hard for us, the hair cellists, like to do to work on broken hairlines, because someone might want a hairstyle that is perfect, or maybe the cornrows that are perfect, and you just find like the hairline is wrong, or maybe it has broken. You start filtering the hairstyle to get that perfect style that she really wants. So I would advise that at least let's try to listen to each other. If your hairline is wrong, try to listen to me, and maybe we can get something that is good. Because I have a lot of people that we have grown the hair back just because of those simple hairstyles that we always do. And most people feel like crochet breaks their hairlines, and this is what I always tell them: Maurice, the crochet master. If I'm the master, then that means that those things that I know that we always do and professionally that makes people's hair to break. So if the crochet that broke your hair, trust me, if it's on me, then it will not at all. Because for me, I only believe that all hairstyle can break hair. Because I've ever got people who come to me when they tell that they come to me telling me that maybe the wigs broke their hairlines, you understand, maybe the cornrows broke their hairlines, others dreads broke their hairlines. But that those who come to me and we do the same thing, and yet the hair comes back. So me, I believe it is the plaiting. The plaiting is the one that makes the hair to break. Most of the times, like you people always want like maybe packed things in front, yet you're doing big braids, trust me, your hair is going to break. But if the packed things and the braids maybe they're small, yes, that is right. So I thought of this hairstyle, and I had to do it. It was my first time, and I created it from my head. And yes, but after, trust me, in just like 2 days, yes, it's even increased my following. I was on TikTok, and most people have been asking me to make that tutorial for them. And here we go. This is it. So we just have to follow all these steps so that we can achieve our the hairstyle the way it is. And I told you that the hair extensions, just because most people always skip the things, but the hair extensions, we always put them in the description. You can go and check it out so that you can get yours and do it right. Yes, and this is how You just have to do it following all these steps. But the procedure is you just have to follow the steps following the bricks building. How can I say bricks arrangement? Like these people who I don't know how I can explain this. The bricks arrangement. You understand? If the first one is from the beginning, that means the second one is going to be the second line is going to start from the second. If now you can see now the first line here, the nautilus starts from the first hair. So the second one, we are starting from the second line. So it means if there is another third one, we are going to start from the first hair. If you try to look at it, that's how it goes. So it means if my steps are three, and let's say I'm starting from the first line, I'm starting with the hair, then it means in the second line, I'm going to put a line there. I'm not going to hold any hair. So that braid skips and goes to the third line. And the third lines, I go with the hair. You understand? So if I'm getting the second line when I start, I don't go on the first line. I'll go to the second line. Like the lines are left there. Oh my God, I don't know how I'm trying to explain so that you can get me, but you just locate from here. If I finish here and I'm going to start another line, it means the first line, if I get this hair from the first, the second line, there's going to be a space. I'm not going to hold the hair there. So as you can see this here, the second line, there's no hair. Then the hair is on the third one. That's how the brick arrangement is. So people who know how to do knotless braids, they already know how to do this. Maybe I'll be coming back to teach those ones who don't know how to do it with the inside knotless, because now that one is also better. Like, it's also good. We need to learn to do it with the inside corners. My name is Maurice, the Crochet Master, and I would like to appreciate everyone who is watching me wherever you are. Thank you so much. May God bless you all. I love you so much. Bye-bye. Let's see this. This is our MDC hair oil. Very, very nice for the anti-itchy. Yes, I have to put it before because I know it right. Then the extensions that we use, we have used here, is all going to be in the description. Get it?